Harris not in yet?
Nope.
I'm doing his filing.
And I appreciate it.
Maybe stop to pick out a dress.
Possibly. Did Harris catch mugging duty?
Yeah.
Oh, Joe, if I remember correctly, you weren't so amused by it last time you pulled mugging duty.
Oh, well, that was a couple years ago. Yeah, I've gained my perspective on it now. You know, I can find the humor in it.
Particularly when it's someone else.
Sure.
Difficult not to feel foolish when you're wearing high heels and stockings and panties.
Panties? What do you wear panties for? No one can see them.
What are you talking about? You gotta wear panties. Don't wear panties, you feel like a tramp.
Gentlemen, we have work to do. Or at least the appearance of work, just for my benefit.
Easy.
Nick, you have filing?
Yeah, I was just waiting for a lull in the conversation. This seems to be it.
They told me downstairs that somebody up here could help me.
I'm Sergeant Yamada.
Do you handle missing persons?
Oh, I do a little of everything.
Could somebody help me?
Nick?
Barney, this is Miss...
Schnabel.
She wants another opinion.
Captain Miller, what can I do for you?
It's my father. He's missing.
All right, just have a seat here. Sergeant Wojo Hovitz will help you. Wojo, this is Miss Schnabel.
Hey, be waiting in a minute.
This is a missing persons case.
Okay.
I guess you get a lot of missing people.
Yeah, well, only if someone's looking for them. See, if no one's looking for them, then they ain't a missing person. They're just gone.
Good morning, Sergeant Harris.
You know what this country needs, Barney?
What's that?
A good depression.
Be a nice change of pace.
I mean, maybe if business weren't so good, these merchants wouldn't be able to afford to jerk their customers around.
I take it you had a problem.
Yeah, I went to pick up my shoes and my hat for the detail.
Pretty tasty.
But the dress wasn't ready.
Why not?
I don't know. Barn, all I wanted done was a few alterations, a little bead work.
Didn't you find a dress that was already,
I don't buy off the rack, Barn.
Nick's already done your filing.
Oh, thanks, Nick.
So, you can pick up a little time by going and shaving now.
Shave?
Shave.
My legs don't need it.
Good.
Smoothness, it runs in the family.
I was referring to your mustache.
Pardon me?
Your mustache. That stuff growing up there on your lip?
Oh, yeah, this. I'd really prefer not to, Barney.
Harris?
Excuse me, Barney, I think I've got to take these things down to my locker.
Harris!
Not too happy about losing the old whisk broom?
It'll shave.
You know, a mustache can become an important extension of a man's personality. Shaving it can be very traumatic.
Gentlemen, let's not make a big deal out of this.
I shaved once. I didn't like it.
Thank you.
can officially file a complaint, we got to know that the guy's been missing for more than 48 hours, so...
Oh, he has been.
All right, how long?
Counting today, 28 years.
Well, it would have been nice if it had been reported a little bit sooner.
It was a little complicated.
Uh-huh.
You see, I was raised in state institutions, in foster homes. Well, I never knew either of my parents. Anyway, a couple of years ago, I decided to try and find him. Uh-huh. But nobody would help me. So I started searching on my own, and I went to the Social Security, and I went to the VA. And through them, I was able to trace him to the place where he works, right here in Manhattan, the Continental Health Spa on Christopher Street.
And he's there now?
Well, yeah.
Well, then he ain't missing.
Well, not exactly. But he won't see me.
Oh, well, see, that's the situation. There isn't that much that we can do about it.
He won't see me because he doesn't know who I am. If you could just make him talk to me, give me a chance to explain, then everything would be fine.
I can't force a man to talk to you if he doesn't want to talk to you.
Why not? It's your job.
No, lady, see, we deal mainly in the criminal element here.
Captain, do I have a right to see my own father, or don't I?
Yeah, of course you do.
No, she does not.
What?
Her father didn't want to see her.
When did this happen?
1950.
Oh, I see.
No, he don't see me. He doesn't know who I am. Stop. If I could just have a chance to explain.
Miss Stabel, this is not a police matter.
He's my father. I've got documented proof. I've got Social Security.
Miss Stabel, that's
notarized things.
That's not the issue.
I've got rights. I suppose you've heard of the Napoleonic Code.
We sure have.
So...
So
it isn't that we're not sympathetic to your problem. It's just that it's out of our jurisdiction.
You're not going to help me at all?
Perhaps we can recommend you to some social agencies.
Never mind. I'm sorry I wasted your time.
Well, we're sorry too, Miss Schnabel.
You don't have to worry about my father and you again. Goodbye.
Okay, Mr. Hawley, if you'll just step inside here, please.
It's all over. My career, my life.
Look, take it easy, Mr. Hawley.
I might as well be dead.
You'll feel much better after you're booked.
Oh, God.
Milton Hawley, he's the host of one of the educational shows at the station.
Mr. Science.
Really? You've heard of me?
I'm afraid not.
Of course not. Who watches Channel 37?
Apparently, Mr. Hawley was performing an experiment on the air when his helper of the day, one Scott McMillan, age 13, began making what he considered disruptive comments.
Boring, Mr. Science. Big deal, Mr. Science. If you're so smart, why are you bald, Mr. Science?
Mr. Hawley finally replied that Master McMillan should either shut up or, and I'm quoting here, he'd put his can on a Bunsen burner.
On the air. I said it on the air. I couldn't wait for a station break.
The kids started laughing at him, and Mr. Hawley went berserk. He chased the kid all around the studio, knocking down the lights, TV equipment.
The station is pressing charges?
Yeah.
What about the kid?
He's suing.
Kids! They're monsters today. Used to be you'd show them how to run a motor on static electricity or how to suck an egg through a bottle. They thought you were a god.
Well, unfortunately, I'm afraid we're going to have to book you, so...
If you'll just have a seat right over
have
here.
Have a seat right here at Sergeant Yamada's desk, since Sergeant Harris has a prior commitment.
Nothing we can't talk about in your office.
Good. Nick, you'll take care of Mr...
Science.
The object is to provide a believable target. I'm afraid the mustache might compromise the situation.
See that? Mm-hmm. It's one of the things I really admire about you.
What's that?
Your flexibility.
That's kind of you.
Your lack of rigidity might compromise. your willingness to see both sides of a question, to bend in a given situation if necessary.
I'm very flattered. What's your point?
I really don't want to shave this off.
Harris.
It's not a matter of vanity, Barney. It's just that, well,
it looks so damn good.
Barn, as a call came in from dispatch, disturbance over at Continental Spa. That's where Miss Snobble said her father worked.
All right, you're in charge. Take him on it with you.
Seen Harris?
No, not since you came out of your office.
Is there something you want to say to me?
I don't believe we've been introduced.
That is a change.
Thank you.
I guess shaving wasn't as difficult as you thought it was going to be.
Nah, on the contrary. Now I'm glad I did it.
Good.
I mean, actually, what is the function of a mustache anyway? It's really just a masculine affectation.
It's one way to look at it.
Well, I mean, it's kind of silly when you stop and think about it. I mean, it's just a stupid clump of hair sitting over your mouth. A meaningless, superficial demand for attention.
Everybody in here,
just leave me alone, okay?
I love you, Daddy.
Well, kind of leave me alone.
Hey, both of you, quiet down.
Hello again, Miss Schnabel.
I just wanted to talk to him.
Okay, what happened?
Well, she went over to the Continental Spa and tried to get in. They wouldn't let her in because it was all men. So she went around the back. Look in the window.
And?
Yeah. Then she went into the locker room.
I just wanted to talk to him.
Now they want to charge you with trespassing.
And it could cost me my job.
Don't worry, Daddy. I'll take care
of
you.
Don't call me Daddy. I am not your daddy. All She's right. A ding-a-ling.
Okay, okay. Nick, you want to take care of Miss Schnabel? Okay.
You ought to put her in a cotton box.
But Mr. Claymore, we would appreciate your patience and your cooperation.
She has been bugging me for a couple of weeks. She's following me around, calling me, invading my privacy. I mean, can't you guys keep her away from me?
Not unless you get a restraining order.
That's it. I want one of them.
Detective Woja Howitz will be glad to help you.
Yeah, sit down, Mr. Claymore.
She is not my kid. I mean, there ain't even a resemblance. Look, I ask you, do we look alike to you?
I'm the wrong person to ask.
Thanks a lot. Stay right there. Harris?
Yeah?
I want to say something to you that I never thought I'd say.
Yeah? Your dress is ready.
Thank you. You gonna come back up and see us before you go?
As the mood strikes me.
You had a grandfather, and a grandmother, and a mother, and a father. Captain?
Mm-hmm.
You had a mother and a father.
Indeed.
So why shouldn't I have a chance to have one? Don't I raise a family?
Of course you do, but unfortunately you can't go around assembling one like a model airplane.
Why not? It could be just the two of us in a house with a yard and a dog and Sunday dinners.
Take that down to the courthouse on Center Street. You can get your restraining order.
Thanks. I mean, they're not going to lock her up, are they?
Not unless she violates the order and tries to see you.
Okay. Because, you know, she's not a mean kid. She probably makes some guy a nice daughter.
Probably.
It could have been any one of a dozen guys.
What's that?
That restaurant was right near the hospital. I wasn't the only guy that went out with Sally.
Sally?
Sally, the waitress that she looks a little like. Sort of. You get my meaning?
I get your meaning.
Goodbye, lady.
Teresa.
Yeah, Teresa.
Goodbye.
Listen, I'm thinking I can straighten things out at the club. You don't have to hold her. You know, I'm the trespassing charge. I'm sure it's going to be okay.
Fine, thank you.
So take care, huh?
You're free to go too, Miss Schnabel. We have your address if we need you.
Thank you.
Oh, your papers.
Don't forget your papers.
I don't want to throw them away.
Listen, I'm thinking. Give me your address. We can keep in touch.
It's all right. You don't owe me anything.
I mean, you know, every once in a while I could drop you a couple of lines. You could send me a card. You know, for Father's Day. I mean, just for laughs.
That would be nice.
You need a lift?
Thank you.
Thanks.
Do you remember much about my mother?
Hey, look, I, you know...
Oh, yeah, I know. It was a long time ago. Almost 30 years.
Yeah. And it was dark.
That Mr. Hawley's bail ticket. Turn him loose. All right, right this way, Mr. Hawley.
Thank you.
That's Mr. Science. What's he doing here?
Oh, there was a fracas in the TV studio. He assaulted his assistant.
No kidding.
I'm very sorry about everything that happened. I appreciate your consideration.
Good luck to you, Mr. Hawley.
Thank you.
I never missed your show.
I beg your pardon. I don't believe we've met.
Oh, Sergeant Wojciechowicz, 12th Precinct. You were the only guy on television who ever sounded like he meant what he was saying.
That's because I did.
Yeah. And I didn't just watch, you know, I did experiments. Yeah, the baking soda in the motors and ant farm. I had ant farm.
I hope you learned something.
Sure. I watch your show every Sunday for 5 years.
Why did you stop?
Oh, well, I had to. Join the Marines.
Now that's a kid!
I'll be checking back in around 6. Oh, listen. What I said to you about your mustache, forget it. I was just upset. Forgotten. I feel much better. You? Fine. You got a little smudge. Oh, thank you. Ha ha ha.
ahead, Nick. Get all your clever little comments out of your system.
You look lovely.
It's true. You do.
Hey, believe me. You look fantastic.
Well, I mean, I know I'm a man in a dress.
My object is to come across as an attractive woman.
Well, I mean, I want to look good, but not better. See you guys later. Yes, Dietrich?
You ever see the movie Laura? It's about a policeman who becomes fascinated by a woman he knows he can never have.
So?
He's playing down the street. You want to see it tonight?
If you were offended by that episode, allow us to be a repeat offender. TV Land brings you another tale of crime, punishment, and bad coffee with Barney Miller next as we stay twice as nice all day long.